Welcome back, YouTube. It is a beautiful sunny day out today here at our decrepit old skate park, but you know, that's beside the point. We want to bring you something a little bit different today. So BMX is evolving and has been since the late 60s and early 70s when BMX was first created. Since then, we've seen a huge development in materials, in features, geometry, and components. In today's video, we're breaking down the top 5 products, in my opinion, that changed BMX forever. Stick around because I'm curious what you guys have to say about this. All right, so starting us out at number 5 is the ever popular Free Coaster Hub. Now, free coasters are one of those things that have definitely evolved over the years. It used to be where guys would actually take the coaster brake hubs, remove the actual brake out of the coaster brake hub, and then that allowed them to go backwards without having to backpedal. Now we're seeing all sorts of new designs. We've got the tried and true clutch-based free coaster like this Odyssey Clutch V1 hub. You've got the cassette-based free coaster, and then now you've got even the planetary clutch free coasters that are popular on the brand new BSD Revolution, and other companies are starting to adopt that system as well. You know, for the longest time, free coasters had a bad reputation for just being unreliable. I will say they're not still quite as reliable as a cassette hub, but they've, you know, improved leaps and bounds over the years. Now, it used to be where only Flatlanders rode free coasters, but then you'd get guys like Ian Schwartz and Bruce Crisman that, in my opinion, were real pioneers in actually pushing free coasters on street riding. Now, within the past 5 to 6 years, free coasters have completely blown up in popularity, and now just about every other pro rides a free coaster hub, so it's crazy to see how they've evolved over the years. You know, I've been lucky enough where I've tried just about every popular free coaster style on the market. Perks of the job, I guess. I do switch back and forth from a free coaster to a cassette. But right now, again, I have the Clutch V1. It's held up for me well. And you know, now they've got a more improved version of that with the Clutch V2. But the only one I haven't tried, the style I haven't tried yet, is the planetary clutch style, like I mentioned earlier in the BSD Revolution. Is the BSD Revolution gonna be an actual revolution that it claims? I guess we'll find out. So coming in at number 4 on my list, grab my bike here. It's actually gonna be smaller gearing. Now by smaller gearing, I'm gonna say anything from a 30 tooth smaller and then a driver from an 11 tooth or smaller. Now I have a 27 tooth on my bike, but the most common gearing these days is gonna be a 25 tooth sprocket and then a 9 tooth driver in the rear, which is a far cry from the 44-16 gearing that we used to see people rock, you know, decades ago. So with smaller gearing, not only did we drastically save weight off our bike, unnecessary weight, we are actually giving ourselves a lot more clearance room, so you're not actually gonna, you know, bash your sprocket on something, especially during grinds, which, you know, everyone these days is rocking 4 pegs, it seems. So obviously you could do things like crooked grinds and crank arm grinds with a 44 tooth sprocket. It's been done for years with that, but, you know, having a smaller gearing definitely just gives you that little bit of extra room. And I mean, some people may disagree with this, but come on, it looks so much better than having a giant, you know, 44 tooth dinner plate bolted to your bike. Coming in at number 3 on the list is pivotal seats, baby. Now, pivotal seats were first developed in the mid-2000s by the company McNeil. Since then, they've just completely taken off to where just about every BMX company out there has their own version of a pivotal seat. And even mountain bike now has adopted pivotal. So it's definitely here to stay.
I guess you could say things are getting pretty serious.
Now, there are a couple downsides to pivotal. For one, you don't get the forward and back motion like you do a traditional railed seat, which there was a pivotal seat out there that had that slider system. I believe it was just called the alienation slider. There may have been another one out there that I'm not aware of, but they did allow for forward and back adjustment on a pivotal seat, not just the traditional up and down. That didn't really take off, so you're pretty much stuck with, you know, just only adjusting up and down. I don't see that being a huge deal. Same with the access patch on top. Some people just don't like the look of that, but now Kink developed the Kink Stealth Pivotal System, which is very similar to this. Same style of, you know, teeth on the actual seat and the post itself, but the bolt is actually coming up through the seat post and not down through the top of the seat. So if you are somebody that just doesn't like the look of that pivotal access patch on top, you can get the Stealth Pivotal and all your problems are solved there. Okay, number 2 on the list. We're getting close. Number 2 on the list is this little guy right here. Oh gosh. Number 2 on my list is this little guy right here, and that's the integrated headset. The integrated headset was a game changer, especially when you're talking about what it replaced, which was the standard headset. If you've ever installed the standard headset, having to use a cup press, which, let's be honest, who actually used a cup press unless you had a bike shop nearby? What you used was a hammer and a block of wood to install that headset. And when you'd hammer it in there, the bearings would start, I should say the cups would start going in crooked, and it was just a nightmare. With the integrated headset, you pretty much just pop the bearings in and you're ready to go. Now, standard headsets and BMX are still around, and they will be for a number of years. But typically within BMX, you only see those on like aluminum race frames and then also on your entry-level complete bikes. That's because the integrated headset has completely taken over, and for good reason. It's, again, like I mentioned, a lot easier to install. It's a lot simpler design, and overall, it's just a lot less weight as well. So that's why it's my number two pick for, you know, one of the most influential parts, one of the most groundbreaking parts in BMX. Now, before we get to my number one pick, I do have a couple honorable mentions. And these are parts that I definitely think were groundbreaking within BMX. They were definitely game changers, but at least for me personally, they weren't quite there to make the list. The first one being the mid-bottom bracket. Now, I don't have a mid-bottom bracket with me here today, other than the one that's actually in my bike. But what a mid-bottom bracket is, it started life as an American bottom bracket. And what that is, if you don't know an American bottom bracket, it was actually a bearing pressed into a cup. And then that cup is actually pressed into the frame, and those are still around. But I believe it was actually FBM that really like pushed this forward. They thought, why don't we just take the bearing out of the cup, make the bottom bracket shell and the frame smaller, and just press that bearing directly in there, and then there you go. That's the mid-bottom bracket. Now my other honorable mention is gonna be this guy right here, and that's the half-link chain. In particular, the shadow interlock, because that's what started the whole half-link chain craze. The original interlock, this is the interlock V2. Now they have the interlock Supreme. And now just about every major BMX company has their own version of a half-link chain out there. Now with the half-link chain, it is just as it sounds. It's the equivalent of a half of a link. And what that allows you to do is with those half links, since they're shorter, you're able to dial in your chain stay length a little bit more precise. Especially on, you know, today's frames, and as frames progress throughout the years, the dropouts themselves just got shorter and shorter. And with the half-link chain, it just makes it even easier. So that's why it deserves an honorable mention, in my opinion, on this list, the shadow interlock half-link chain, or just half-links in general. All right, so it all comes down to the number one pick. And again, this is my number one pick for top five products that changed BMX forever. And you guys may have different opinion about this, but my opinion, I think I'm kind of right on this one. And I'm curious what you guys think. Let's argue about it in the comments. I'm sure there's somebody that's gonna disagree in there, but you cannot deny how much of a game changer this was in BMX. It's kind of a two for one. That's gonna be plastic pegs and plastic pedals. That's right, plastic within BMX.
Cold, shiny, hard plastic.
Now, when people first heard the term plastic, I know myself included, you think just, okay, some cheap plastic material. Well, these days they're all made of some proprietary blends. They've got like different polycarbonates. They've got fiberglass injection molded into them, stuff like that. So they last quite a while. They're plenty strong and you really don't have any issues with them. It wasn't until I think probably the Odyssey Twisted PC pedal where plastic pedals really took off. And I mean, those were affordable. They actually gripped your feet. That was a big issue with the early plastic pedals, in my opinion. I don't feel like they gripped very well. And they lasted a lot longer than you thought they would. With plastic pedals, again, like with crank arm grinds, pedal grinds, things like that, that plastic material is gonna slide a lot better than having an aluminum peg against concrete or any sort of rail for that matter. So that's one of the advantages of it. Obviously, the disadvantage is that they do wear out. With the plastic, the pegs, for example, you have a replaceable outer sleeve. So once you do wear out, you can just pop this off, pop a new one on, and you're good to go. And that's the advantage of plastic pegs, is you can pretty much grind almost anything fairly well. All right, so that's my top five products of parts that I feel changed BMX forever. Now, I know there's a ton more out there that I'm sure I completely, maybe I thought of them or I completely overlooked them. Let me know in the comment section what you guys thought of my list. Let me know what your top five would be. Maybe this is something that we can revisit later on. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see everybody in the next video.